So a couple of weeks ago, I brainstormed 6 thumbnails that I wanted to base paintings off of, and you guys really liked them, so I've just decided I'm gonna make it a series. This was perhaps one of the most difficult ones I could have chosen to do because I am my own model and she's supposed to look sad, and I couldn't keep a straight face because I was trying to take pictures of myself looking like sad and my mom just kept laughing at me. I also tried to like make myself cry, but I'm a very ugly crier, so I ended up just looking diseased. I ended up compiling like 5 different images to get like 1 decent reference, and I wasn't happy. I figured out what was wrong though. She looks dorky in reverse. Perry the platypus? Now, I've got a question for all my painters out there, and I need you to be honest with me. What do you wear when you paint? Because I've seen so many videos of painters like wearing super cute clothes or looking nice, and I wonder if they do it just for a video, because I straight up wear pajamas. I know a guy who wears a Batman onesie. My pajamas don't even match. That was a Perry the Platypus t-shirt with galaxy print leggings. And there is the final product, not to toot my own horn, but I'm actually kind of pleased with this one. Let me know if you guys want to see more.
What to draw when you're bored? Draw a dot. Draw wavy lines from the dot. Draw curves in between the lines. And repeat.
In the town where I was born, lived a man who sailed to sea. And he told us of his life in the land of submarines. So he sailed out to the sun till he found the sea of green.
Leave it to me to wait 4 days before Christmas to start on an oil painting that I'd planned to make as a gift for my grandmother. I wasn't really sure what to get for her because it doesn't seem like she likes a lot of things, but then I remembered she likes my artwork. She used to pull my artwork out of the garbage and then put it on the fridge, you know? And then I remember a couple of weeks ago she saw my self-portrait and she really loved it and she wanted a copy, and I thought, I'll make a portrait of Grandpa for her. Grandpa passed away a couple of years ago from cancer, and all the pictures that she has of him are pretty old, and she doesn't have any really good color photos of him, so I figured I'd get on that. Painting this was surprisingly difficult, but also very therapeutic in a way. The picture that I ended up using as reference was taken while he was sick, and I subconsciously found myself changing it in certain ways. Things like filling in his cheekbones and adding a little bit more color to his face. They're really small changes overall, but they made it feel a little bit more like him. I'm also painting my mother something for Christmas, but she has a TikTok and she follows me, so I can't show you what it is. And there's the final product. Not bad for my 4th portrait ever.
A girl that stood out from the rest. Poison ass can be with a high power chest. Michael Biggins here, and I'm running the show. Bell, Biff DeVoe. Now you know.
Yo, slick blow.
It's driving me out of my mind. That's why it's hard for me to find. Can't get it out of my head. Miss.
Scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul and seal your doom.
What does wetting the back of the canvas do? It also helps get rid of dents on your canvas. Anyways, back to the before and after.
So, I don't think people realize how easy it is to draw a realistic looking eye. First, draw an oval that's kind of pointed at the edges. Then draw a circle in the oval. Then draw another circle in the circle. And another circle on top of that circle. Fill in the pupil completely black. Make a line a little bit higher than halfway through the eyeball. Lightly color it in. Get a Q-tip and blend it out. I know this part seems kind of hard, but you can do it. Bestie, I believe in you. If you're feeling a little extra today, get a white colored pencil. Fill in the third circle. A little bit on the bottom. A little on the sides. And boom, just like that, a realistic looking eyeball. Good luck, happy drawing, and follow for more.
They don't know I do it for the culture, goddamn. They say I should watch the shit I post, oh goddamn. Say I'm turning big girls into hoes, oh goddamn. They say I get groupies at my show.
You said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
Take me to church, I wish like a dog at the side of the light.
Yeah. known as flawless. F1, I keep shooters up top in the F1. A lot of bad bitches begging me to F1, but I'ma eat them rat bitches when the chef come. Throw some fresh ones. More talent in my motherfucking left thumb. She ain't a Nicki fan, then the bitch deaf dumb. You ain't my son, you my motherfucking stepson.
I don't know what Larry look like.
Hit the door.
Bitch.
Boy, you can hit it. Shit though is
happy. Let the party begin. I would do something I never did to you, girl. I would tell you what I should do about you, girl. Tell your friends you ain't coming down tonight. From your head, girl, tie it up tonight. Lay your head on my pillow. On my pillow.
You can draw. Day 43. 1 minute drawing tutorial. Rectangle. Line in middle. Swoopy lines on each side. On bottom two. Connect. Slanted line and more lines for the pages. Outline and can draw lines like this for flipping pages. And done.
Here's what I do when I want to draw straight hair, but not make it look too flat. I draw the hair curving a little bit. Same for long hair.
Seriously, did you not read the colony policy that defines you as company property? That wavers your say in autonomy. The conglomerate's got you in lock and key. We put the dollar back into idolatry. If you're upset, you can rent an apology. We are a family forged in bureaucracy. No I in teen, but there's con in economy. Were you expecting adventure? Were you hoping for fun? My friend, you're in
tips for beginner painters. Before using your canvas, make sure to wet the back of it with water.
Don't pop like trouble breaking into your heart like that.
Cool, it helps make your canvas tighter.
My mother, high like summer, yeah, I'm making you sweat like that.
Break it down.
Ooh, when I look in the mirror, I'm not too hard to do. I got the superstar glow.
Make sure to get every spot. You can rather use a paintbrush or a spray bottle. Spray bottle is better. When you think you're done, you can let it dry or get a blow dryer.
Where you been at? On the road, but I just got back. And I'm still fly than the and your boyfriend, well, he just not that. And I don't know how to behave. I'ma tell her be safe. I don't need a b***h, I'ma tell her be safe. I got God with me and he's telling me things. I wanna see some, I wanna see some. Baby, can you do it like that? From the front to the back. She said I don't wanna move too fast. She hit that gas, so rockin' a puff puff pass. Now the whole squad gettin' up ass. Oof, I'm just tryin' to see some. I ain't gotta say it cause they know where we from. I got some money out the ATM.
My teachers tell me that I'm really fast at painting, but I think it's literally because I do this. So I always start with an acrylic base because one, it dries so much faster, and two, most likely it's going to be opaque so that if you layer anything on top, the base color will already be there. So I'm going in with an acrylic base for like my entire dress, my face and everything. And now I'm going in with oil. So this is all oil and I'm carving out my features like it's a sculpture and adding depth. And like, I know a lot of people don't do it this way, but like it works for me. Look at this. Look at this.
I think I'm getting butterflies, but it's really something telling me to run away.
No, hey, low, baby, I'm the reason why hell's so hot.
It's really not that bad. It just needs a little shaping. To the salon!
Get the cool shoe shine.
guys, so I'm bringing back the quick doodle tutorials, this time cottagecore edition. Here is how I draw a mushroom. I start it with a cylinder base, add a rounded triangle for the top, and then an elongated oval inside at the bottom, connect it with all these lines, add polka dots, and there you go. Let me know what I should draw next.
I've been reading books of old, the legends and the myths, Achilles and his gold, Hercules and his gifts, Spider-Man's control, and Batman with his fists. And clearly I don't see myself upon that list. She said, where'd you wanna go? How much you wanna risk? I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman.
I just wanted you to watch me dissolve slowly in a pool.
Something that I often like forget about myself is the fact that I don't see the world in the same way that everyone else does. And by that I mean that just artists in general, I feel like, have a different perception of the world. For example, I do more realistic work, so that means that I look at everything in terms of shade and light, and whenever I see people's faces, I see where the highlights fall and I see where the darknesses fall instead of the whole face. Whereas my art teacher, who's a comic artist, sees it in terms of lines and shapes, which is so interesting.
Cold as ice and a heart made of stone, but she keeps me alive.
Locked up me, acting like it's not the deep. Oh, you can take it out of me. Tell me what it's about to be. Really feel this bound to be. I can't tell no one but I got a man, but I want you. I got a man, but I want you. And it's just nerves, it's just dick, making me think about someone new. You know I got so much to say. I try to hide it in my face and it don't work. You see through that I just wanna get with you when you're right. You're right.
If this is how you normally draw your braids, this will make them look a lot more realistic. Start off with a heart and then make a chain of hearts overlapping each other. Bring a curvy line down the center of each one, then add your shading. Finish it off with the ponytail at the top and the leftover hair at the bottom.
Out of my head, out of my mind, if you let me, I'll be out of my dress and into your.